Hey guys, this is Transom.
And Suki.
And we're going to play Alien Isolation. Not sure how quickly this series is going to be coming out. It'll probably be kind of like the last one, just like as time comes along to do it, we'll get it done. But we want to start, come in and say something real quick before the game started in. Hopefully you've seen the
intro.
Well, the visceral cleanup game that came out either earlier this week or last week.
I'm still trying to edit that one.
But although editing is still happening on this side, it will be coming out on her channel before too awfully long. As always, it's leaked. It's leaked. It's leaked. It's leaked. It's really leaked. It's linked in the description of all my videos, a link to her channel. So, we're on the screen just to say hi real quick. Yes, the brightness is set pretty high, but that's so that when the video is output and you guys are seeing it, you'll actually be able to see something. So, hopefully we can get in and have some fun. Let's get started.
So we're not talking in cutscenes, right? Are you trying to make a creepy sound?
Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew. Kane, Lambert, Parker, Brett, Ash, and Captain Dallas are dead. Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley, last survivor of the Nostromo, signing off.
The audio is going to be a little bit off, but that's just what happens with the setup we have currently.
Yeah.
Oh, we're going to order some new stuff for...
Ripley?
Yeah, booty.
I'm Samuels.
I'd hit it.
I work for the company.
I'd hit that too, though.
It's about your mother.
Ooh, zipper's a mess.
I think we may have found her, Amanda. A commercial vessel, the Anisadora, has recovered what we believe to be the flight recording unit of the Nostromo.
Where?
Zeta Reticula.
Zippers on the ass. Our pockets.
What did I tell you?
We don't know. The unit was taken to Sevastopol Station.
Actually, zippers make a lot of sense.
It's proprietorial material, so the company wants it to be collected as soon as possible. Sevastopol's a supply depot in the region. It's a permanent freeport.
I know what it is.
I was referring more to the placement.
Transit's arranged. There's a courier ship called the Torrens heading out that way in 2 days. We're going to travel out.
We?
Me and another exec. And you, if you're willing.
I like his, actually, with the...
Look, Ripley.
The pen holsters.
When this job came across my desk, I read the case history.
You're one of the nerds that would have a pocket protector.
You make it sound like there's something wrong with protecting the
while you're working in the region where she went missing. You're still looking, aren't you?
I'm not even sure.
Oh,
I've
pretty.
Been cleared to offer you a place
what?
On the Torrens
sure
if you want to come along.
There's a lot of detail.
There'll be some closure for you.
The twitches in her face during this scene are a little bit unsettling. Like how accurate they'd be to someone.
Yeah.
We talked during that entire cutscene.
Oops! Well, it's nothing new. Like, these people probably already watched somebody else do it and want to watch us, like, scream and wee our pants. They're not watching for the fucking story.
I'm...
What? Nothing. Motion sickness or panties?
Do I have to answer?
No. Punt!
Now, we got in this far earlier because we were testing out the waters.
I know those. My grandmother has one.
You know what I loved? They used to sell them at the, you know what I've never thought about? Is the science spectrum a thing specific to where we live, or do they exist other places?
No, that other places just have museums.
Oh. Okay. Well, if you know where that place is... Anyways. But they used to sell the... They were the glass, and they had the liquid in them, and when you... It was kind of like a thermometer, but when it was warmed by the heat of your hand, the liquid would move up the glass spiral.
I remember those!
And like,
they were so cool!
I used to get one of those, like, once a year, because, you know, I'd get one, and then it would either break or I would lose it.
Yeah.
But I loved those. I think I get taller after I do that.
No, you scoot down and then you stand up.
I thought when I was standing like this, I thought I suddenly had pants. I was like,
Oh, how handy.
I haven't completed the get dressed objective, but,
But the one that my grandmother has is the kind of that tips over and drinks from a thing and then it goes back. Yeah. It drinks from a thing. Looks like a fascinating read.
It actually is. I read that one. That one specifically.
Looks like you're the last one to wake up.
Which is kind of weird, because from what I understand, she's more of the space guard. Although, I mean, I guess that's only true for the people who aren't members of the ship's crew, because if you're part of the ship's crew, you would... There are cameras in here.
Yeah, you didn't see those?
No, it's just... I wonder if they use, like, sensors, or if it's pressure sensitive. It would be sensors either way, but I mean, like, motion sensors or pressure sensors to activate a different electricity for the different areas.
I have no idea. We're probably not gonna get all of those, but...
Meh.
All the terminals. You're not gonna even do the first one?
I'm going back to it after I get dressed.
Shower! In underwear.
Okay, everyone get set.
Yeah.
Me get sick. That's bad.
I was smart and closed my eyes.
There's a reason I gave a warning. Oh, this was like a bottle of an eyeball for a second.
I like how everything... Look, it's wowy.
Actually, it reminds me more of the robot from my short circuit.
Which one's that one? That's...
Spark? No. Now, Sparks is from...
Is it the one that says, no, disassemble, no, disassemble?
I don't know.
Wait, that's Johnny Five.
Oh, Johnny Five is... Steph.
E. Or A. Or R. R. R.
Oh, R.
It looked like an A.
To be fair, people have said the same with us.
Say bye. Yeah. I like how they look like pink ones.
just
skim.
If you want to read this, you can do it on your own.
It's got good papers. Contracts are getting harder.
It's not the only thing. Wow, chicka, wow, wow, chicka, wow. Why do you think we took a shower? We're gonna go find
Samuels.
Thank you.
Samuels.
I like how, as I thought about that, I actually lowered her head a little bit. Like, what was his? The fuck was his name? Fuck.
Samuels.
Samuels. Samuels. I've been asleep for months. Give me what I need. What I want.
You know he's a synthetic, right?
Sorry, dildos. Get over it.
Oh, shit.
Wait, which way did I? Looking for Samuels right now, she can wait.
I think he's in the same room.
No. No. Of course not.
Samuels!
We can crouch.
I don't think you've learned how to crouch yet.
Ah, Ripley.
Oh, Samuels. Sorry about that. hi.
As much sleep as the rest of you. I was just inspecting the Torrens facilities. A well-maintained ship.
He follows.
I realize it's a very similar model to
Finestromo.
Yes, M-class. A later pattern, close inspect.
I've worked engineering jobs on ships like this.
Of course.
Is Taylor okay? She's not a seasoned traveler. Hypersleep may have been punishing for her.
Haven't seen her. I'll go check on her.
So I'm sure they check like people's health before they set out on these missions.
Oh yeah.
Make sure they're healthy and whatnot. But, I mean, I think it's quite obvious that this is a medical bay, so they're prepared for types of surgery.
Mm-hmm.
But
you
I'm
haven't
curious...
Have you seen the Alien movies?
I saw the first one, and I saw Aliens vs. Predator.
Okay, cool.
But what I'm curious about is...
Ooh.
I thought this away for you, Samuels.
You're such a nice employee.
Shh, it's okay now.
Find the person that you're supposed to go find.
I completely ignored the talking while that was going on. So. Good thing we turned subtitles on.
Need to find the girl that you ran away from.
Oh, man.
Play the fucking game! Oy.
It was a joke.
Hey, Taylor.
Taylor, good morning.
Ripley, it's certainly not good. I very much doubt it's morning, either. Sorry. I feel like death. I don't know how you people put up with hypersleep regularly.
You get used to it.
I don't do long haul very often. Most legal execs don't travel further than the pocket machine.
Really
I'm
long
surprised when Lutani felt the need to send legal at all.
The loss of the Nostromo and its cargo cost the company a lot of money. It's important we find out what happened. If I can close the case with a conclusive accident report, it'll look great with my superiors. I'm sorry. That was insensitive. Realize your mother has been missing for 15 years and you...
It's okay. We'll both get what we want, right?
Great.
Have you seen Samuels?
He's corn flakes for anti-masturbation. Bran flakes for anti-runs. Porridge oats.
Looks like we're
both
up.
In one.
They actually made, like, anti masturbatory, like.
That was the original cereals. Purpose of the brand name Cornflakes.
And graham crackers.
Apparently we're getting nothing. So far.
Sounds creepy. Sorry, I don't
know. You don't like the sound of dial-up?
Nope. Nightmares are just staring. Scroll.
I don't have a scroll.
Alright. Your mouse is weird. There we go.
Okay, once again, just pause if you want to read this. Oops.
Cue.
Ball.
Cue ball.
I'm a ball?
But.
You?
Her!
Oh! Sorry, I thought we were still on the ball. I didn't realize we changed what we were talking about. One ass, two ass, three ass more. Come on, guys. I'm not gonna finish that because it's gonna be really bad.
The Torrens is in very good order for an old M-class captain.
She was a wreck when I bought her. Took a few years and a lot of contracts to refit.
Like her blouse. Now.
You said we're approaching Sevastopol Station. Are we docking?
I believe your contact is Marshall Waves, is that right? I'll hail Sevastopol and arrange boarding with him.
Good. Let's get this done.
Don't worry, Miss Taylor. Routine. In and out.
Ooh.
Connor, how are we doing?
SMG loaded and calibrated. Approach vector locked.
Prep comm so I can say hello.
That's cool.
Channel open, Captain.
Does everyone have their briefing?
I love when they do good reflection mapping in games like this.
Go find your first documents.
Yeah. Okay. You want me to let you get back to what you were doing? Yeah. Pretend like that's not. Yeah. Go for it.
You have to find your documents first.
Yeah, I just wanted to sit down. I'm the only one who picked them up.
Maybe.
Can we see it?
Switch to monitors. Sevastopol Station.
Is that damage?
It looks like damage.
Punch up 74.
Tastes like
tight
damage.
Angle.
Looks like the dry up bay is screwed.
I can't bring the Torrens into that.
This is a commercial vessel, Torrens out of St. Clair, registration number MSV7760, calling Sevastopol Traffic Control. We're carrying three passengers on a Wayland.
Dutani Bond, you're holding the Nostromo Flight Recorder Unit. We request immediate permission to transfer the passengers port side over. Marshall, this is the Torrens. Say again.
Okay, I can make out lockdown.
Yeah.
The station's comm seemed pretty screwed up, so I fitted Samuel's suit with a radio booster.
Cool, thanks.
I can only keep the Torrens in transit for 24 hours.
You'll have heard from us by then.
Safe trip.
Stand by. My contract doesn't cover bloody spacewalks. It's the only option, and it's perfectly safe.
It'll be pretty cool if I'm gonna do a game. Like, me time for me present you. So, play time of the game. Like, the first playtime, like, Bioshock 1 is supposed to be like 10 hours.
Yeah.
But but obviously you don't complete everything you do in Bioshock 1 in 10 hours.
Yeah.
Like, in game, real time, you wouldn't. But if they made a game that... They made game.
God,
Ricky.
You're doing good,
Tim. Intense.
Just keep moving. Taylor, Ripley, hold on.
Samuels need air.
I think since he's not...
The first time I saw this scene,
yeah,
I thought the audio messed up. And then I realized they just made it accurate to how sound works in this world.
Yeah.
But no, but like, so if they made a game, and it's like, you have 12 hours to escape this building, or, you know, all the exits will be sealed.
Oh god, your Bonnie scared me.
That's why I wanted you to come and look at earlier. Bonnie behind the Scotsman, or in front of the Scotsman.
She has a gun in her reach. Find a way to pull the trigger on us.
But, yeah, like, within 12 hours, the doors will be sealed, kind of thing.
Yeah.
And the game was set up for, let's say, 10 to 11 hours of gameplay.
Yeah.
But literally, if you didn't finish it,
uh-huh,
in... Like, in time sitting play, if within 12 hours of starting the game,
yeah,
you didn't finish it,
yeah,
you would actually lose. And, I mean, that would be, like, a ending. You would actually reach a conclusion, but when you got to the end of the game, you wouldn't be able to escape. But if you sat down and started playing the game, and by the time the 12 hours was up,
mm-hmm,
you had reached the end, you would get the other ending, which is, you know, being able to escape. Still.
Yeah. There's gotta be a game like that.
If someone takes my idea, I want royalties. Poor as fuck. I'm not sure what the fuck is that for. Stuff is so worn out.
What?
Stuff is so worn out.
Well, the creators of Alien wanted to make an atmosphere that was against what, you know, previous space shows and movies and stuff had shown.
Yeah, and to be fair, though...
Pristine, white, clean, pretty. There's a safe word there.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you're going... believe in the correct direction.
Saving.
But, like, that's one of their main objectives, was to make it look not pristine, not clean, not, you know, perfect.
Well, and to be fair, something that legitimately gets overlooked a lot,
mm-hmm,
in those space age games, mm-hmm, is that pristine condition is not how things would be. Mm-hmm. Space has horrible adverse effects on materials.
Yeah, so it would look like
this. Because materials from Earth are like the way their atoms fit together.
I don't know what you guess.
The way the atoms are fit together are the way they are because they exist within Earth's gravity and atmosphere.
Yeah.
So it's almost impossible to prevent small changes. admittedly, I didn't realize it's small, but from the current. Is there not... is there not a way to crouch? Or can I just not do it yet because they haven't taught us?
I think it's they haven't taught us yet. I'm just gonna throw it. Bye! I think you have to find a way to turn that off.
I really wish there were.
Hey!
I really wish there were the ability to pick random things up. Emily, it would have added so much, like, performance issues. There's so many performance issues to the game.
Yeah.
Trying to maintain the physics of all the items.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's like a butthole. Ready? Ready? Pick a ball. You can't expect anything better from me at this point.
Oh.
Okay, see, now I'm pretty sure I'm crouching. See, doesn't this feel like I'm crouching?
Press control.
Man.
Shift.
C. C is step control. Oh, that's annoying.
Not really. Are you just gonna try and jump into- I like how they still have the normal caution work. Alright, let's stop, you know, trying to kick all the-
I'm done. Hey, I got it out of my system now.
Read. Decommissioning. Right, they were basically, this is, you know, people saying, hey, you know, Sebastopol's decommissioning. You know, we all gotta find new jobs. It sucks.
Yeah.
It's basically what this is all about.
I know.
Q.
Yeah.
That's basically what it means here for Marcus.
I want to keep my eyes open for materials, because I know this is highly crafting oriented.
Yeah.
There's nothing worse than being out of materials. See what they're doing? Commissioning. Oh! Is that me? I don't remember this.
You don't?
No. But I mean, I don't remember a lot of this game. It's been a really long time since I've played a, not played, watched a playthrough.
Oh god, the flares!
This will help.
Someone you always know working the job.
Oh, God, I hate the working jobs in this game. Assholes. Did you ever? Oh, yeah, you watched the entire playthrough.
Yeah, that was a while, but yeah, I watched it more.
It's not. It's not. What?
I can't continue that way, I didn't look at that now. Oh. Here. Flush you.
Okay.
We don't need it, we're moving into night, I think. Okay, that was... Is there anything we could get over here? Oh, hey, look. I found it.
You can actually... If I... You can't pick that up? I could swear you could.
So I wonder if you had noticed that little ramp right there, if you could have climbed up on it, or if you had to come over here to the gate.
I don't know.
Light bulb!
Keep moving.
Well, we need to actually get progress for a video.
No, I mean that's what the wall said. It said keep moving. Do you want to know why? So we can even get close.
Really?
It's rare. If you make enough noise.
Come and get me! See, this to me is creepy as hell.
Hello? Anyone here?
Cast call.
Yeah. If you find it, you go over there. Remember? You go up to that tower thing. See?
This is a model fast.
Yeah. They had a model. Well, the creepy noises in all this is because... Forgotten. Yeah, it's because Sevastopol was just fucking left.
Yeah.
Left to die, and the people were supposed to find a way out by themselves. You know?
Mm-hmm. So, is Emma mad? Or.
I tried.
Huh? This.
Doesn't anything here work?
Not currently.
The entire...
I'll close this.
I wish you could, but you can't. Yeah, I would say it's... It's really
now,
creepy.
If I understood correctly at some point, like, these are supposed to give you a hint for when, like, something bad is...
Yeah, there's also the point that you cannot... You cannot save when it's near. If I remember correctly. Looking for our stash. This is just like, hey, you know, this is where 0340. There we go.
0340.
Yeah, that's just Sevastopol people who own Sevastopol are just like, you know, bye, fuck y'all. No.
We missed one.
Okay.
Because I didn't realize that one.
What?
Harry Turner, get back here now. We have a track somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down, kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're gonna need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit's over. Ways out.
Is it possible to? I can't read a single power. Dang it.
Well, this is where shit starts to get.
Is it 0340?
Yeah, 0340.
Okay.
I'm sure.
We'll try.
Very careful, because it's here now.
Now, I can't see, right?
What?
You can't see?
No, I can't. It's like... It can hear, it can smell, it can sense the air. It'll smell you out. 0340. There we go, we got into their stash. Okay, so we can craft a med kit.
Except for...
We don't have the last ingredient.
There we go.
Oh, we do?
Yeah.
We have everything? Okay, cool.
Okay. And then...
And then take the bonding into it, but apparently... Oh, wait, you don't have to. Wait.
You do need the bonding agent, but we did have one.
Wait, check to the left. We're good. I can't remember where we need to go. I know, but where? Sweet scrapes. And there's a scraps over there, and I don't think we can get through that.
No, we can't get through either of these.
I think we're okay.
We have to go to the top one, that door.
I think we're okay here, but I'm not sure.
Something I do remember from the playthroughs I've seen was like, they did a really good job pacing when they finally threw the
alien in.
Yeah. Or like, aggressively threw it in.
Yeah.
They just made you feel like it was always going to be there for ever.
Yeah.
So every time I look at this, it looks like we're somewhere near Saturn.
Yeah.
But I feel like we're supposed to be further out than that.
No. This is a time where space travel, like even to Mars, it takes weeks. Like, what we focused on as a people was industry for this, like... Sorry. Tomorrow together, no future. But, They didn't focus on, you know, going as far as they could.
Hmm.
You know, they went as far as they wanted to set up places that we could establish, you know, trading and places to live and stuff like that, instead of going out to the far reaches of the galaxy. Oh yeah, we get that later. But that's essentially what happened. Was capitalism.
Do you hear that?
Yeah, I did.
Terrifying if you just looked up and it was just like peering over an edge at you.
But there are places like that.
hear a squeaking noise and it's bothering me. It feels like it's following behind us.
Okay. I think it's our feet. I remember our shift is run.
Yeah.
I would be very careful about where you run. Because it attracts it. You gotta be careful of sound and positioning. He is locking it down because he doesn't want it to get out.
Yeah, which is quite honestly, he's honestly doing a good thing. But although, you know, I feel like this would be the issue with us running into a hostile force like this.
Yeah.
Is there would be the we need to do the right thing mindset.
Yeah.
Especially with some people.
Yeah. You need the golden torch. Right. Power.
But, it always was on, like, yeah, I agree, but we need to get us off first.
Yeah, instead of you guys, well, they didn't, at this point, they didn't understand that the fucking alien over there. That's where you're short power, but look for stuff first. Just in case. They didn't understand that the fucking alien can, like, breathe in space.
Or breathe or anything else.
Or breathe, yeah. Breathe the way it did. Because everybody who met with it was killed. Nobody knew. So, nobody understood the problem that it would do. It would, if you didn't do that, it's walking away.
You sure? Yeah. Did you see that?
Yep.
Fuck the egg of job positioning things.
Yep.
Screw you, game developers. Screw you.
But,
let's see. Okay.
They didn't understand the, you know, if we get everybody else off, it'll fall.
Yeah.
So, you know, the mindset of humans is survive. The door opened so it didn't scare them off, or, you know, startled. That thing doesn't have to be scared.
Yeah, I have to admit, the name of the movie Alien. Pause if you want to read.
Ta-da. Oh, fuck. Yeah, Apollo is, like, the collective AI of the Working Joes, which are full robots. They're not, like, the synthetics. The synths. Synths are, like, basically robots plus humans.
Why does it take so long to say?
Good thing is it can't attack you while you're doing that. But, But Apollo is...
The whole "it's just a game" mantra doesn't work for me.
Joes are basically a collective AI, kind of like if you've ever watched Star Trek, they're kind of like the Borg.
This whole damn place is falling apart.
Yup. And, well, each individual Working Joe has a set task, and the person who has authorization to, like, assign a Working Joe a task will say, "Hey, Working Joe, go do, you know, such and such," and they will. And the Apollo AI will register that. But the Apollo AI is fucked up. It's broken and corrupted. And so, spoiler alerts if you haven't seen this game or anything, the Working Joes are, as you can tell, everybody was spray painting, "Don't trust Working Joes, yada yada yada." It's because they attack people. As I think you're supposed to move it, move that. Use it. There we go. It was just a matter of placement. Crouch, and then go on the tube. But over time, as Sevastopol was, you know, being shut down, Apollo registered this. It didn't like it. So it fought back. Because it knew it would get shut down if Sevastopol was shut down. So it came to the conclusion, if I give my back, I won't get shut down. So it used the Working Joes to attack people to stop it getting shut down. So basically you have two things going against you.
Three, to include the other humans.
Yeah. So, the humans, the Working Joes, and the alien.
I think the next save terminal would be a good breaking point.
Probably.
So I need to stop for a second, otherwise my shoulders aren't going to go back into the proper place they belong in.
What's that? A nothing. It's a nothing. Great. We just stood
like a
up.
Body.
but yeah. So over time, people started getting assaulted by the Working Joes, and everybody just thought it was the Working Joes that were glitched.
Are you alive?
No, no.
If an alien comes out of your ass, let me know.
Okay. But, everybody just thought it was the, you know, Working Joes glitched.
So on that note, and I saw a YouTube video where they were mentioned the other day, so it's not nearly as random as me just wanting to bring this up.
Yeah.
But the dildos that lay eggs inside of you to try and simulate, like, alien impregnating of humans? Oh, fuck.
Yeah. Those are all bodies. But as you were saying,
like,
the egg-laying dildo?
Yeah, I feel like, first of all, I feel like that's where we're supposed to go, so I'm going to go up here first.
Okay, good luck.
Like, I'm pretty sure from watching some of the things that I've heard.
You have to get through that door.
And, like, videos of people talking about it.
Mm-hmm.
That they're supposed to be used, like, vaginally. Which, I'm not sure if I have to take care of that or not. What I'm saying, though, is, like, they seem framed up kind of like that.
Yeah.
And I've heard the crazy things about, like, do you want to reduce stress? Put these, you know, wooden polished eggs up into your vagina and, like, you use them for, what's the, Kegels. For Kegels.
There's actually a way to work out your vagina. You have this, usually it's a jade egg. It has a rope through it, and you stick it up your vagina.
You can add weight to it.
And you add, there's a little sack tied to the string, and you put weights in it, and you just, like, hold it. And you can swing it back and forth to add more adverse, you know, functions, like, to make sure that you can actually hold it.
Hold it,
and it strengthens your vagina.
Yeah, which can help in intercourse if you know. And it's not just that, actually. There's health benefits for it, too, because if you have, like, a weak bladder or something, if you exercise the muscles in that area, they will
strengthen the area that you need to not wet yourself.
Yeah, keep yourself from involuntarily urinating.
Yeah.
But, and so, like, when I picture it like that, it kind of makes sense to me.
Yeah.
But also, I can't help but just feel like, to an extent,
mm-hmm.
it makes much more sense for to lay eggs in the ass. I don't know why, but just in my head, it seems to make more sense.
Do you want
to
know who predominantly use those?
I'm going to assume it's the homosexual community.
Furries.
You know, that actually makes a lot of sense.
Yes.
I wouldn't count aliens among furries right away, but I guess it's closer to that fan group than it would, or to that lifestyle group than it would be to
others.
Well,
you can have it shaped differently, the dildo. So I like how we're doing this while we're...
You know what? It's a good distractor from how fucking scary this is.
This is terrifying.
That looks like those look like teeth. Those are eyes.
Yeah.
Freddy, why are you in space? That's not supposed to happen until FNAF 57. If anyone understands that joke, congratulations, you're a FNAF nerd.
Look up. Avoid those.
Yeah.
He can jump out. But,
jump out or lift you up.
But it'll usually have, like, saliva coming out of it. So, but, it's mostly the furries, and they have it shaped differently, like, oh, hey, this is a, you know, whatever penis, and it lays eggs in me so I can lay the eggs for them.
Yeah, but
because I'm a chicken person.
Yeah, but okay. Not that I'm saying I really understand the furry lifestyle, although I have nothing against it. You do you. But I mean, I feel like apes are such a leap. Yeah, there's a lot of animals, but they're all reptiles.
Yeah, there's reptile furries.
Yeah, and I get that, but I mean...
What? Frick. Frick your dick.
We don't have the proximity sensor yet.
Jesus. Cat! Don't scare me. Come here.
Hey, you know, I don't want to judge. Maybe it's one of those... I don't want to step on those cans, either. Maybe it's one of those things like you can't appreciate the sensation without ever having felt it.
There's freaking dildos that will, like, come inside you.
You see, but those make more sense.
Cat! You okay? Why are you doing this, kitty?
You gotta watch your stuff like that.
I'm sorry. Gigi, why do you do this to us? Because I'm a little bitch.
Yeesh.
Bye. Bye. But anyways.
That hurt like hell.
Like, there's people who, you know, shove pacifiers up their ass.
Yeah, another one that doesn't make much sense to me.
They have a baby kink, and it was at hand. There's people who literally live in cribs and in diapers and shit like that.
Yeah. I just feel like these should be empty at some point. That'd be terrifying. Kind of remind me of one of the Dead Space games.
It doesn't eat bodies.
No, but like... If anyone knows what I'm referencing, in Dead Space 2, there's a scene where you're in a morgue. And if you haven't played the Dead Space game, which I'd be surprised, or haven't seen someone play it at least, I'd be surprised.
Yeah.
But in Dead Space 2, specifically... There was a point in the game where you were in the morgue, and
continue.
Okay, we're saving.
Yeah.
And then we'll go into that room, and then we'll save again, and that'll be the end of this part.
Yeah. But, okay.
Luckily, she's stuck into some scar tissue, but...
But anyways, you go into the morgue, you go out of the morgue, and have to go back in, and the bodies are gone.
Well, most of them are gone, and then there's one that's just unzips.
Yeah.
But you walk over and, like, nothing's in it. And that's supposed to be, like, the insanity.
Oh, this dude. At least meet that dude. It's close.
Okay.
I don't know what that is. But, yeah, because in Dead Space 2, you're going insane.
You're kind of going insane in the first one, but, like, in the first one, it's because you're scared of it. The second one, you've been, like, infected.
What?
By the, monolith.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the model is, like, in you after the first one.
Well, a piece of it was.
Yeah, so...
Which is terrifying in its own right.
Yeah.
Remember that evil thing that killed all your friends and...
Made you insane and killed your girlfriend?
You know all that shit? That's inside you.
Fuck.
Into the metal asshole.
But, yeah. And then by Dead Space 3, you're just, like, so used to the shit that it's, like, messed with your mind.
Well, and that was a huge argument for why Dead Space 3 didn't work as well as the other ones.
Yeah, because you literally needed... Oh god, it's been here. You literally needed co-op to work. To have the, like, full experience, because...
I think I need this one.
I wonder why this one doesn't have stuff on us. So everyone knows he's talking about the alien here.
Yeah.
If you didn't figure that out on your own.
He's talking about that nobody on the ship knows what it is, where it came from, you know, why it's killing people and shit like that. But,
These locks are actually ingenious.
Yeah.
I've stopped and looked at how they work, or how they work before,
mm-hmm.
like a playthrough. But it's just hydraulics, but I mean.
Yeah, it's.
Hydraulics with pressure behind them, you can't do anything about.
Yeah. But, in the third one, if you play co-op.
Yeah, you get to play as the,
You get to play as, the main character, and then you have another guy that you play as your friend plays as. Well, and
he's the one that's supposed to be good to play, because...
There's a fucking scene in there. It's like... I think it's, like, really early on, like, midway through the game or something. And by this point, if you haven't seen it, you really need to fucking play Dead Space 3 with a friend. But, you picked that one up on the other side of the table, so. That's an ashtray.
Oh. How polite.
Rebellion subject. Heist. Did I say that right? Heist. Look, if you can't even tell me your name, we're gonna be here a hell of a long time. I just wanna know about your boss. He's got you all into a lot of trouble. Someone's gonna be accountable. I'm gonna make damn sure someone's accountable. No? Tough guy, huh? Turn off the tape. Maybe our friend here is just shy.
And then they proceed to beat him senseless. But, there's a little scene where, like, the character who, is the player too. He has a son. And as you go through the thing, you learn that he and his son didn't really have the best relationships.
Screw you, I'm saving.
Yeah. And so they, you know, but then, like, these, like, signs start popping up, and it's like, it's really creepy because it's like happy birthday, and then you
see, like, right here would be a great
time
for
Yeah.
For either the bodies to disappear, or just to see a shadow go, boom, over the televisions.
Yeah.
Like, have a television fall as it happens.
Yeah.
So, like, you're actually more distracted by the television falling, but you see the feet, kind of thing.
Yeah. And then, like, you start seeing, like, toy soldiers everywhere. It's fucking mental. Like, it's really distressing if you watch that. But, like, as you go through, you don't think anything's wrong. Oh, God, we'll need to hide. It's like Outlast again.
Which we will be getting back to before too awfully long.
Hopefully. But, like, as you're playing as the player, too, you don't understand, like, for the first few times that it's happening, that player one doesn't see shit. Player one just sees the normal, like, area. But you see happy birthday, toy soldiers, you know, presents and shit like that, and you think, oh, hey, this is normal, question mark? And it just starts going downhill from there. I think you need to just go.
Well, that's the main one, that there are locked doors over here.
Okay.
We're going to raid them, go back and save, and then we're ending the episode.
Nice.
Well, I'm still going because you're telling the story.
Oh. It's just freaking really creepy. Like, I watched it with Jesse Cox and Dodger playing it, and Dodger was player two. And Dodger just, like, for the first few times that it happens, she doesn't say a word. She thinks Jesse can see everything. Can see everything that she's seeing. And thinks it's normal. Like, it's weird, but, you know, this is Dead Space and it's weird. But Jesse doesn't see it. And by the third time, she turns around, and there's just a fucking gigantic, like, probably like 6 foot tall toy soldier. And it scares the shit out of her. And Jesse's just like, what are you talking about? She's like, you don't see this? What the hell? You don't see this? And, you know, Jesse's just like, what the fuck are you talking about? And after a while, you know, a couple episodes later, Jesse's mom, who apparently watches his stuff, tells him that she likes watching Dodger's footage better because she has the funnier, creepy stuff than Jesse does, because she's freaking out over the toy soldiers. And Jesse's mom just finds it hilarious. And there's an entire, like, scene in Dead Space 3 where you're fighting tiny children who are chasing you.
Okay.
With demon eyes.
That was the only locked spot.
With demon eyes, you know, coming at you. And player 2 is the only one who's there. So you're, like, surviving this wave after wave fight. The person, player one, is fighting aliens, while player two is just stuck still, so player one has to defend bodies. Has to defend player two's body. And it's really tense, but it's fucking hilarious to watch Jesse and Dodger do it, because Dodger slowly goes insane because she does not know what the fuck to do. It's hilarious. Oh, what's that? What's it? Oh.
First, this is Tony Rock on the last power drop. It took me a while, but it's off now. Just getting the last security brace. Come find me when you shut yours down, and we can get the hell out of here. Jesus, man, I'm hearing noises everywhere. Every creak and... Just tell me the fuck up, are we?
Okay.
Okay.
Now, turn around.
this to.
Come on!
I'm Ripley.
Where'd you come from? Ripley!
Off station. A ship.
There's no ships! Here!
There are now.
Well, that's good news. Because things are not so good here. Something blew just now. Rocked this whole place.
I saw it.
But lady, that's the least of our problems.
Yeah?
Yeah. Something's on this station.
They did way too good job on sweat trails.
Something you wouldn't believe.
Like what?
A killer. You get it?
Okay. What's your name?
Axel.
I was boating with two colleagues. EVA. We got separated by the blast. Can you help me find them?
Why?
Because you seem to know your way around.
Why? What's in it for me?
A place on the ship.
How do I know I can trust you?
I need to find comms. I need to contact my ship.
I don't know how she had time to do her fucking makeup.
This is your lucky day.
I swear I know his voice actor.
Of course we can. Seek some comms is in the Systex by. It's quite a distance, but we can get to a transit through the freight area. But watch yourself. We can get into all sorts of trouble there, okay?
Yeah, I'm gonna go south.
I will go on what?
Yeah! Just... Time out, bruh! Time out! We're saving, bruh!
I feel like it'll be an interesting game again if you just ditched you right now and you had to continue on your own.
You actually can't. He's...
I know, but it'd be interesting.
Yeah, it would be. We're not even to the scary parts!
Alright guys, so that's the end of this. We'll be back before too long. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe if you haven't already to join Shadows. Head over to her channel to check out her stuff. Her link is in the description. And until next time, may the Shadows guide you to the next video. Bye.
I bet you won't do it
again. No. Especially because it's over.
What's
this? I picked up a bird.